Hi, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of The Good Life Today. Today, we will be speaking with three guests, Karen Reyes, Socrates, and Antigone. All three of these guests have exemplified tremendous amounts of virtue and continue to fight for justice in their everyday lives. As usual, viewers will submit questions to Twitter for each of these three guests with the chance of their questions being answered live. Now, time for our first guest, Socrates.
Hi.
Hi, it's nice to meet you. So this is Socrates. He's a 71-year-old philosopher from Athens, and he's a man regarded of high virtue and morals. However, he's recently been accused of corrupting Athenian youth and not believing in the gods, and has been sentenced to death. However, many feel that the judicial system is not treating him fairly. Hi, Socrates. Thank you so much for being on our show today.
Thanks for having me.
So this trial that you've been a part of, it's been really big in the news. What do you think of the outcome?
Well, obviously I'm not thrilled with the way that it turned out, but the jury decided the way it did, and that's that, so we're going to have to live with it.
I see. So a lot of people think that you've been wronged by the justice system. What do you have to say to them?
I'm flattered by the support, but like I said, they decided the way they did, and there's not really much we can do about it at this point.
Mm-hmm. And so if they were, if the jury was to take back their sentencing and release you instead of kill you, would you continue living life the way that you were?
Absolutely. I think if they were to decide to let me go, then they would realize that what they were doing was wrong in the first place by putting me in jail and sentencing me to death. Mm-hmm. But even if they didn't feel that way, I think I would still go and live life the way I was before, because that's what I believe in.
So do you think that you're living the good life?
I think before I was thrown in jail, I was living the good life because I was practicing what I believe in and I was able to live freely. And now I think I'm still living the good life because I'm standing by what I believe in.
So we're actually going to take some questions from our viewers now on Twitter, so let's read those. Our first tweet is from Miletus, who says, "How can you live with yourself knowing that you are corrupting the minds of Athenian youth? Can't wait till you're put to death."
Actually, I don't believe that I was corrupting the minds of the youth, because if I was corrupting the minds of the youth, then I would be corrupting society as a whole, which would include myself, and I wouldn't want to do that. And also, if I was corrupting the youth, it was unintentional. And don't you think the death penalty is a little bit harsh for an unintentional act?
Our second tweet is from Credo, who says, "Why are you so content with your death sentence, even though everyone knows justice is not being served? Why won't you just escape prison and live your life elsewhere?"
I've already done all that I could to prove to the jurors that I'm innocent, and they already still think I'm guilty. So if I were to try to escape my punishment there, that would be unjust in itself. And if I were to do that, I'd be a little bit of a hypocrite.
As many wants to know, what are your tips on how to live a full life of virtue?
To have a life full of virtue, you must have an open mind at all times, because if your mind's closed, then you're closing yourself off to the outside world, and you'll never be able to reach your full potential.
Our last question is actually from one of our viewers, Professor Bailey. She says, "Hey Socrates, what are your thoughts on the modern day justice system compared to how it used to be?"
I think the modern day justice system has made a bunch of great improvements, because it's a lot harder to take people to court for smaller reasons. The courts are much less biased, and the punishments are much more reasonable than they used to be. So we're going to continue to keep making the courts better, I think, but right now it's made great improvements from where it was.
Now joining us from 1960 Chicago is Karen Reyes. Karen is a young detective on the hunt for the truth behind the mysterious death of her neighbor Anka. Although she is young, she believes that she should stand up for what is right and just for Anka. So, Karen.
Hi,
nice to meet
you.
So, Karen, you've had a pretty rough year this year. Your mom passed away, your brother Deez has been distancing himself, your neighbor Anka was murdered and you still don't know who did it. How has that been for you?
It's been hard, but I have some good friends to help me, and hopefully I'll get to the bottom of the second half of my story soon so I can figure out what's going on.
Mm-hmm. And so, you began sleuthing with the whole Anka mystery. How did you go about that and why?
Well, Mama definitely told me not to be nosy, but I really just had to figure out what was going on. I knew that if I didn't do it, the police certainly weren't going to investigate any longer, and I just had to find justice for Anka.
Mm-hmm. And did you feel any pushback in your investigation?
Definitely. Like I said, the police did not think that there was anything going on, so I knew that if I didn't do it, nobody would.
So what kept you going on with the investigation?
Well, I just knew in my heart that there was something wrong, and I knew that the more I found out, the more information that I got, the more that I knew I had to do something about it.
But why didn't you just take the easy way out and listen to the adults?
I don't know. I guess it crossed my mind, but like I said, the more I knew and the more I found out, the more I had to keep going for Anka's sake to find out what happened.
And do you think you'll ever get to the bottom of this mystery?
I don't know. Maybe by next Halloween?
So in conclusion, Karen, do you think that you're living the good life?
I guess so. I have been through a lot recently, and it's hard to keep up with it all. I don't know what's going to be coming next, but I really do. I want to know what, get to the bottom of what Mama was hiding. I know that she was being secretive, and I have to know who killed Anka for her sake. I have to get to the bottom of her situation.
And now we're going to take some questions from our viewers via Twitter. So our first tweet is from Antigone, who says, I understand fighting for justice for those you love, like I did for my brother Polynices, but you didn't know Anka very well, so why was it so important for you to solve her murder mystery?
Well, it was important because even though I didn't know Anka very well, I still needed to figure out who did it, and so it wouldn't be deemed a suicide or somebody innocent would be blamed. And especially after listening to Anka's tapes with Mr. Silverberg, I knew that there was so much more information, and I couldn't just keep it to myself. I had to, it would be immoral or unjust to hold on to that.
So our next tweet is from Socrates, who says, I like that you were searching for justice for Anka and not accepting things at face value, but what do you see as a just punishment for Anka's murderer, whoever that may be, even if it is your brother?
Well, I really don't think it's for me to decide what a just punishment would be. I think that's for the courts. Whoever that murderer may be, if it is my brother, I don't personally think it is, but if it is my brother, they should go through a fair trial with a judge and a jury, and they should be the ones to come up with the punishment, not me.
So our next tweet is from Andy Hutt, who wants to know, why can't you just accept Dee's murder in Anka? If you really want justice for Anka that badly, wouldn't you just accept his confession?
Well, Andy, I would say that Dee's couldn't even kill my father, who he really did not like. Why would he go after Anka, who he loved very much? I won't take his confession at face value just yet, because I truly believe that my brother did not kill Anka. I don't think he has it in him.
With us now, live in the studio, is Antigone. Antigone comes to us all the way from Athens, Greece in 400 BC. She's here to talk to us today about her decision to stand up to her uncle and bury her brother Polynices. This, of course, was in a time when burial rites were extremely important. So, come on out, Antigone.
Hi.
So, Antigone, what was going through your mind when you found out that your brother Polynices would not be receiving a proper burial?
I was devastated. I know that my brother did some bad things, but honestly, everybody deserves a proper send-off to the underworld.
It must have been hard to deal with all that grief while fighting with your family.
It definitely was, and my family doesn't have a great track record for getting along very well. It can be hard when your morals conflict with your sister or your uncle, but even though I knew I was going against Ismene and Creon, I knew what I was doing was right. I had to do it for the people of Thebes and for the rule of the gods. They're more important.
So you think it was a right choice after it was all said and done?
Absolutely. I wouldn't have made a different choice. I had to do what I had to do for the gods.
So, do you believe that you're living the good life?
Hard to say. I've definitely struggled a lot in my life, and having a family as messed up as mine definitely didn't help. But doing what I had to do to save my brother was the right choice, always. And not doing, or following Creon's rules would have been a punishment worse than death. So, I would say I'm living the good life for standing up for what I believe in.
Agreed. Having integrity is hard, but holding on to your morals is always better than losing them.
Absolutely.
Now we're going to take some questions from our live viewers over Twitter. Our first tweet is from Missy, who wants to know, how do you feel comfortable standing up to authority figures? I always want to stand up to my mom, but I'm too afraid to. Any advice?
Well, I definitely agree that first you have to know who you are and what your morals are. So once you figure out what you actually believe, it becomes easier to fight the battles that you need to. And I know it's especially hard to fight battles with those who are closest to you. So if you can't have your mother on your side, try and find somebody else to be in your corner, maybe a friend or a close friend.
So Miletus wants to know, how do you know that going against the king was the right choice? I think that the rule of law should be considered above all else.
Knowing if you made the right choices is difficult, and I do believe that the rule of law and the word of the king should always be respected. However, the word of the gods must come first. They guided me and my choices to bury my brother.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today. I hope you learned a little something about our guests and the good life as a whole. Be sure to tune in next episode when we talk to Karl Marx about the common good. See you next time on The Good Life Today.